press in the trunk. Bury got junk in that trunk. Run that sack up for his gun. Try that gang, watch it get slow. Dip with the trash in the trunk.
Y'all, it's your girl Lola K, and I'm with the Propane Gang. I got T-Long, De Niro, and Drip Doug on me on the scene. So they just went ahead and dropped the album on Wednesday. So y'all tell me a little bit more about the album.
Yeah, man, this Propane Mafia fit out right now. It's been real. It dropped June 13th. You know what I'm saying? Doing a crazy number right now.
The all nine track produced by me.
Yeah, so.
Okay, so like, what are y'all's main goal in music? Like, what is the main goal of this year? Not like over time, you know what I'm saying? Later.
To plant seeds, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Plant seeds, get new numbers, you know what I'm saying? Not just in the city, but outside a different city, you know what I'm saying? Different states, you know what I'm saying? Just leaving them with music here, music there, you know, consistency.
Okay. So what's mostly important to you when it comes to your music? Is it the quantity, like the checks you're making, or is it the quality of your music?
Right.
Are
now,
you trying to get a message out there?
Quality, because I figure, you know, there's a lot of talent, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of people with the ability, but you gotta just know how, you know what I'm saying? Everything right now is self-made, you know what I'm saying? So that's what we're trying to do, just showing everybody we're self-made. You know what I'm saying? I guess that figure, you know, why we feel we underrated, because everybody else, you know what I'm saying, they got people that's, you know, helping them and stuff like that. But like I said, just been self-made.
So mainly, so like artists today, you see a lot of, well, mostly on YouTube, like you see a lot of them, like, that are independent artists that we've never even seen, like, you know, going commercial, like NBA YoungBoy or a 21 Savage. I like 21 Savage.
Yeah.
Throw that in there. But like, you know, you see other artists like Jada Youngin, and then there's, what's the dude name? I forgot his name, it blew me. But you have, you know, like artists like that we haven't even seen or heard on the radio before that's actually making money good off of their music. So is that one of the main goals that, you know, trying to get your name out there on YouTube and World Star and such as that?
Right, that's the main objective.
Yeah.
The main objective. What we're trying to do right now is basically, like I said, about us putting free music eventually, you know what I'm saying? It's showing everybody we self-made. You know, like I said, you come up to somebody and you give somebody something free, it's like, you know what I'm saying, they're getting them a bliss.
Yeah.
Like out of nowhere, that's why we're trying to go out of town and out of the city. We just, here you go, bro, you know, we ain't charged. Yeah, there you go.
Check it out.
I was like, damn, you know what I'm saying, good crap right here when they really is. So see, they like, man, who did niggas here right here? That motherfucking gas, man. That motherfucking free gas, man.
Okay. So, I know all of y'all are a group, but y'all each have, y'all have y'all own thing going on, too. So, each one of y'all have an album coming out. Not an album, but a mixtape coming out, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go ahead and start with you. Like, what's up with your music? What's
I'm
your
doing
style?
Right now, well, this is what everybody be like, damn. Because I'm doing R&B music and I'm rapping. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, I've been singing for a long time, so you know what I'm saying? But I always got bored. And so what I'm trying to do now is, like, summertime, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I guess you ain't just really hearing, like, I know my cousin, shout out V.I. Champ, man, he just dropped the volume, you know what I'm saying? Damn, like, and he's R&B, you know what I'm saying? It's just fire. And shit, so you know what I'm saying? Right now, I'm dropping R&B shit.
Okay.
Same time. I've been here supposed to be dead, but called after hours. And coming on my birthday month, you know what I'm saying? July, you know, cancer.
Okay, so we got the singer rapper of the group. Okay, so Zero, what's up with yours? What's your music style? Like how you go? How you rock?
Never trap. Never trap.
Okay, never trap.
Yeah, I got my own meat tape, my trap out come probably at the end of August.
With your music, like, what's your goal personally with your music and getting your messages across doing that? Due to that, it's trap music, because I like trap music.
Like, I'm just sending a message, you know, to all the travelers, everybody that grind, you know.
Yeah.
You know, trying to put them on.
Give them a little motivation.
Yeah. All
right, okay. Okay. Yeah. All right, and my God, Doug. So, you know, you got one coming out, too. So, what's up with your music mixtape?
Well, basically, it's basically about, like, like finding my sound, like being more versatile, you know what I'm saying? Like me finding me, like, you know what I'm saying? The name of the EP got the Drip EP, of course. You know what I'm saying? It's just basically like the movement, but it's a type of style. You know what I'm saying? Drip is like a whole style. Like a lot of folks look at it like, you know what I'm saying? My drip, like my clothes or the fabrics I'm wearing. For me, it's like a whole movement.
Okay, so you believe that your music could influence people's clothing perhaps?
I mean, it could. It could, but you know, it's a whole new style. A whole new way of being here. So you're trying to bring something whole new to the human hill, you know.
So have you ever just thought about doing a clothing line due to that? You like clothes and you drip dug, so you know, you gotta come up with something like a drip dug, you know, company or something like it.
I was thinking about doing a drip way or no way or clothing line, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was thinking about doing that, you know, because, you know, girls like bikinis, jewelry, and with bikinis, you know, okay. And stuff.
You know, you just send one your girl away, cause you know I love clothes.
Oh yeah.
But you know, y'all. So I mean, due to that, y'all are a group together. Are there any challenges within working together? Cause it's three. I see y'all got like the way that I'm talking to y'all and having like you know talk. Y'all seem like y'all vibe like legit. Yeah, but cause y'all got some type of same tendency. Like some kind of same style that y'all could vibe with. That's why I was like, okay, you can tell that these people are group, but I know there are challenges in a group. So, like, what are some of the challenges? Like, whether it's recording, whether, like, whatever, like, what are some of the challenges of being a rapper?
I wouldn't say it's relevant challenge because the only thing is just, like, time management.
Yeah.
You know, other than that, I'm like, when we get in, it's just, like, it's chemistry. Propane got that sound with the boat, you know what I'm saying? And then Drip Dug just with them bars, nigga, like crazy, man. Them motherfuckers, like, damn, you know what I'm saying? Nigga, like, shit. Nigga, like, on and on and on. But you know, that nigga me spit that shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? And then with me, you know what I'm saying? Like, I get in there, then you know about me being like, you know, I'm 29, I'm 30, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, and that just kind of explained the kind of music I'm making now, you know what I'm saying? You know, I have not with them, you know, so I would play. They're good and just show them what's the best example. But you know what I'm saying? Like right now, I'm just really just trying to, like, just show them. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, consistency. Like, my boy love it. And we know it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That music like crack, you know what I'm telling you? Man, for real. Like, we got that sign. We got that. We in the way. Like,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so when y'all do make it, don't forget about your good. Don't forget about me. You know what I'm saying? I just want me a shirt. I don't even want no money though. I just want me a shirt. I just want all y'all records, like, you know, that y'all get, you know, famous on or whatever, so I can play something up, so I can be like, yeah, bro. You know, I did an interview with them. But yeah, bro, like y'all gonna make it up good, cause y'all got some good music. Be sure that y'all do check out their mixtape that came out Wednesday, The Propane Mafia Effect. Y'all have to listen to it, cause I said so. So you need to listen to that. But so like now we're about to go on some personal questions. Like with each one of y'all straight from it, cause you know.
Okay.
So I'm just gonna do random, you know, I'm just gonna be choosing out of each one of y'all, just random hobbies. Okay, so like what besides music, De Niro, what other besides music, like what else do you like to do?
Travel, be on that grind.
Travel. Okay. So like I know y'all planning on, you know, taking my cousin to the city, out the city, cause you know, I ain't been out in a minute. When y'all get out of country, y'all hit me up now, cause we gonna plan to go on to Rio or something like that.
Right.
On my birthday, we going to Rio. Y'all birthday. Look,
see,
I ain't been to the casino. Yeah. My hand been itching. I probably might trip on it. I hit. Let me see. So I could tell that y'all all got chill personalities, but between all three of y'all, which one of y'all would be the most outgoing? Like, if somebody just come in and be like, hey, bro, you know what I'm saying? Y'all thought having a party and he wants y'all, like, y'all ready to go? Y'all ready to get down? Like, who would, like, the first be like, I'm ready to go? Like, they go fuck this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, just be like, we could pack our bags and go.
Shit, you know? Shit. It really be like the whole game.
That's
you know?
Right.
Yeah, so like, y'all all ready. Okay. Okay.
Like a rest now.
Yeah, because you know, some people, like, you know, you'll have some people in a group of friends that just, one that just like, I don't know, girl, like, that just too skeptical. Then you got one that just like, let go, baby, we ain't, you know, no time soon. Then you got the one that actually just sit and be like, I'm with whatever. So that's why I ask, because, you know, some people actually just be like, I don't know, because, I don't know, some people, I don't know why people do these, but let me see, let me guess, what else? Oh, well, so music-wise, who influences you?
Well, like I say, I've been doing R&B music for so long, and like I say, the influences, like H-Time, you know what I'm saying, I don't know if it's big, but H-Time, you know what I'm saying, I'm for like, a group, Keith Sweat, Joe, you know what I'm saying, I'm bored up, you know, baby, with that baby making me, and shit, like I say, I'm an 80s baby, I'm the only 80s baby, but I'm representing, I don't give a fuck, you know what I'm saying, that's all good, though, I'm representing my 80s baby, shit. But see, like I said, man, as far as like hip hop, like who influenced me, shit, it's crazy. Cause like out of my top five, you got like I know Pop. You know,
yeah,
like,
oh, of course.
That nigga's just like he was like 40 times. You know what I'm saying? I hate that. You know what I'm saying? Gone. Cause I know right now, if he was right now, he would really be making niggas step up the wall.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And knowing that, like, he really kind of paved the way for reality raps due to what's, like, for versus, you know, today, how music is today. They still got reality raps, you know what I'm saying, through trap music. But then, like, when you listen to on the radio, well, nowadays, you just hear stuff that you want to hear. Like, I like Migos, you know what I'm saying? They do reality raps within some of their music, but then they blast their music on what people want to hear. I'm not getting out on them, you know what I'm saying, because I fuck with Migos. I love them some white. But like, yeah, man. But seriously, that's what's up though. Who influences you though?
Really, music period. Cause you know what I'm saying. I was raised off of music, like blues, really to be real. Like I was raised off of blues, like rap. You know what I'm saying? Like old throwback rap, like you know Ludacris and you know some other genre. You know I was raised about that. But music period just influenced me just to go up. And the little fan people, like, you know, the fan base I have, people telling me like, when you gonna drop this? Like, when y'all gonna do this? Like, you know what I'm saying? It's coming soon. You know, I got you. You know, the work it continues. But,
okay,
you know.
Okay. That's what's up. Okay, so basically, y'all are saying, like, y'all want to influence people. Y'all want to plant that seed and also let other people know that y'all are consistent.
Yeah.
And that y'all look good. The way that y'all are so chill right now, y'all, I'm not even gonna lie. Like, I'll be ready to go ahead and, you know what I'm saying? Let me be y'all manager. Let me manage. We're gonna go ahead and get this
done. That's
what I'm talking about, man.
To be way down. Money older than the cougar. Shout out to Moon. I'm stashing these bands in the sand. Jimmy Splash, you know you.